Hey guys, welcome to this 3DVista tutorial. In this video I want to talk about animated PNGs. So as you can see right over here we have like animated PNGs, and if you want to add something you can go to animated, and then you can find all these animated PNGs by clicking on them and you see how they move. But sometimes you just want to have something custom made, your own color, stuff like that. And so to do that we need to make that in a program. For this video I'm going to use After Effects because I'm familiar with that. There's other tools such as DaVinci, I believe, to do this. The main purpose of it is that you're able to create a PNG sequence out of it. So creating a PNG sequence in After Effects. I already got my circle in Illustrator, so I'm going to import that one. But this could be any PNG, any logo, any image. So you can just drag and drop that image inside here. The same when I'm using the Illustrator file. Now I have this image, and as you can see, nothing's really happening. I press Ctrl K, which is composition settings, or Command K, and I use right now 250 pixels by 250 pixels. For me, that is currently more than enough. I might try a little bit lower than this, but this is something to play around with. At least try to at least keep it below 500 by 500. Bigger than that is gonna cause a lot of trouble with animated PNGs and loading times. Then I use a frame rate of 30. I'm not sure if you could go lower with it, and I have like a duration of 2 seconds. So this is what I use here. I'm going to keep this animation very, very simple. I click here. Well, I have shortcuts, so I use S for scaling. You can also just go through all these things and see what you can do. But I'm going for scaling. I'm going to add a keyframe. I'm going to 1 second. I place this on 90%. And I am going back to 2 seconds and put it back to 100%. Playing this, this is the animation I've made. Now, I think this is good enough. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to Control M, click here, and then here it's a PNG sequence. I choose for RGB plus alpha because it's I want the transparency to be transparent. And I'm going to give this output a location. Render. So now, as you can see, this is what I've got. I've got 60 items. So, well, that's correct because it's 30 FPS by 2 seconds. So 60. Now I've got this PNG sequence and I'm going to use APNG Assembler. I'll put the download link in the description. Then you just select all these files and drag and drop them inside there. Compression settings, these are turned off. Okay. Delay all frames. And here I'm going to say 1 out of 30, because 30 is the FPS I've used in the composition settings in After Effects. Say set. I give this a name. Make animated PNG. So now I'm having this animated PNG. Going back to 3DVista. Just starting here. Image. Insert new element. And here I select the file I just named Zero Shape Tutorial. Open. Click in here. And now I can do a lot of things with it, with like the settings. So first, let's see how it looks like. So this is how it looks like. Now, I like to play around a little bit with this and see what kind of options there are. So I like to do it, apply a sticker turned off, because right now you're seeing this, but it gives a little bit of the pixels around the edge. And with this mode, not applied as a sticker, it is more sharp. So, as you can see. But it also, the shape is also growing and shrinking according to the zoom level. So that's something to keep in mind. Now, if I want to attach this to, for example, something as a screen here, let's put that right over there. Right now, I might say, put this to the circle. So this right now, apply a sticker is turned off and the scale mode is set to fit inside. Vertical alignment to the middle, horizontal alignment to the center. So that means like center, center. So it will now stick exactly to the corner of the screen. I'm going to say preview. And as you can see right now, it stays to the center of the to the corner of the screen. Now, if I want to put this more to the corner to make everything accordingly, fit more like this. Now, this is not the right shape to try this corner with. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to not say bottom, but middle, because there's this line. This is more fitting in there, so like this. So now you can see that the line this on the middle left is exactly matching with the screen here, no matter where I look. So the alignment is important, or something to play around with at least. Then something else you can do is to say a hover effect. So what I like to do sometimes, right now it's 54 by 54. I might make this very large and say fit inside none. So right now it's the 250 by 250 ratio that we set in After Effects. And I say play on rollover and pause on rollout. And what that means is that this whole area is now a clicking or a hover area, basically. And because I've set the alignment now to none, the scale mode, means that I can place this also anywhere I like. So I can say now, place this to the corner of this thing. Oh, we added a little bit too much opacity in the image. So now it's going to be harder to exactly match with the screen in this case. We'll see how far we get. And so even if I am looking here with my mouse, this will then play. So right now, I go with my mouse and it plays. I go away and it stops, it pauses. And now I go here with my mouse, it plays. So you could basically sketch the areas in the panorama and determine based on the part of the panorama you're watching what needs to be activated. And now we've got this, it's also going to get easier to make different shapes, such as the one for the ground. And we go to After Effects, go back to the shape. We make this a 3D shape and we say rotation by pressing R. And let's see, we take, yeah, this one. Something like this. And we just Control M, click here, PNG sequence, RGB plus alpha, okay. Boom, boom. Render, APNG assembler. Control R selecting them, delete, remove them, drag and drop the new ones, double check the compression settings, they're all good, delay all frames, 1 by 30, all good. And I call this make animated PNG. And as that's happening, I'm already adding here my image, insert new element. And this is done. Boom. So there we have it. Now you might want to be a bit more careful with the amount of pixels. So if not needed, such as here, because right here, you're not using all the pixels, all the resolution. So you might control K and then crop the amount of height to something like this, I think. Let's see if it works. Yeah, you could even make it smaller. And then just do the same thing over again. So I hope this video helps you and designing your tours a bit better and nicer, and hope to see you in the next video. All right, have a good day. Oh, before you go, after I created this video, I checked in with a rule. Rule basically said, well, 250 by 250 is already quite high resolution. Try lower that. So I went instead to 150, as you can see. And also, another thing is to lower the frame rate from 30 FPS to something like 8 to 15, something like that. So what I did is I went for 10 FPS, and this is the circle, 10 FPS, 150, 150. So this is already kind of like the size usually hotspots are already. So I went back to After Effects, Control K, change this, as well as the frame rate to 10. I went through APNG Assembler again. Now I set delay to 110 because that's the frame rate. And in 3DVista, what I have to do is I have to set the FPS here to 10 as well. And then preview this. So that's it. And the reason why this is important is because of this. So when you're exporting, you get these files, and basically what 3DVista is doing, it just adds up all these images into one large image. So checking this, with the 30 FPS, we're getting an image, one image of 1750 by 2250. And this is a size of 499 KB. I've had tours where it was very, very slow at 2 MB. So I had to reduce this a lot. Now this other one, 10 FPS, 150, 150, is only 600 by 750 pixels and the size is below 100 KB. So that's already like a lot. Now, if you just want a very easy way to reduce everything, you just go into Photoshop and you take this image and you basically halve the resolution in the export, or you change the color of that, for example. So you could say here and go for like 50%. So if you still want to halve the resolution, you can do it this way, save it, but then you have to save it exactly in the same folder with the exact same name as this. So if you don't do that, it will not take effect. If you do it, you replace it easily. And you can also change the colors. If you want to read more about that, you can check this in the Facebook group. So that's really it. I'm really going to end this tutorial now. Thanks for watching and see you in the next one.